You could sum up 2019 at the Port of Caddo-Bossier with three words: battles, barges, and beginnings. Let's start with the battle. In 2019, it was against Mother Nature. A rising Mississippi River and repairs at locks and dams along the Red River caused barge traffic to come to a stop in May. For 169 days, barges could not reach the Port of Caddo-Bossier.
What was unique for us is the flooding that occurred in 2019 was a result of the impacts of the Mississippi River and not the Red River. This is the first time it's happened since 2011, and though we had these impacts, we were able to help our customers in every possible way.
Finally, in November, the inspection and repair of Lock 2 was complete, and the barge drought ended. Not surprisingly, the first barge to make it to the port was carrying steel coils. Steel coils was the top commodity at the port in 2019. Vulcraft Texas, a division of Nucor, continues to use the Port of Caddo-Bossier to transfer steel coils from barges onto trucks, which delivers them to the company's plant in Grapeland, Texas, which is south of Tyler.
One of the first barges we received in November was for Centric Pipe, a company located in Bossier City, and they are an example of a company that does not have a facility at the port, rather just a facility where we offload the steel coils. And we anticipate them to continue growing their coil shipments this year.
Centric Pipe is one of the new beginnings at the Port of Caddo-Bossier, but there were others. 2019 brought a first for the port. A barge containing bags of urea arrived. Sacks containing nearly 1,800 pounds of urea were offloaded at the port. Urea is used at a plant in the Dallas-Fort Worth area, where it's used for the manufacturing of diesel exhaust fluid, which in turn reduces the amount of air pollution created by diesel engines. Also in 2019, a new beginning for port rail service. Railing, a subsidiary of Genesee in Wyoming, took over rail operations at the Port of Caddo-Bossier. Because of the port's growth in barge and rail traffic, the port would have needed to increase the size and the expertise of its rail team.
By bringing on RailLink, which happens to be one of the leading rail switching companies at ports in the world, our operations team was able to focus more on our maritime and ground transportation multimodal facilities. Overall, we've been able to improve the level of service to our tenants and customers.
Also in 2019, Benler Steel became the first customer at the port to receive designation as a foreign trade zone. This means the company is exempt from paying customs duty on imported raw materials. Work also began on the port's new 100,000 square foot heavy industrial warehouse, which will be used to house commodities before they're ready to be moved out of the port. Also in 2019, the port implemented a new mass emergency warning system for both tenants and employees. The system allows port officials to issue alerts of any emergency. Shortly after it went online, it was used to warn port workers of a tornado warning in the area. Employees took refuge in stairwells while the storm blew by. 2019 was a big year for the port staff, and 2020 will be even more exciting. This year, the port will mark its 40th anniversary. It was 1980 that the first 828 acres were purchased for the Port of Caddo-Bossier site. Today, the port has more than 2,600 acres. And in June, we'll mark the 25th anniversary of the first barge to arrive at the Port of Caddo-Bossier.
2020 is going to bring us an opportunity to purchase additional tracts of land, which will help us in our mission of recruiting and retaining business and industry for the area. And as we continue to do that, we're going to be mindful of the investment that the citizens of Caddo and Bossier parishes have made in the port, also being good stewards of that investment, and also being a good neighbor.